Hi there, thanks for coming today. Our team consists of Yvonne, Adam, Tamir, Antonio and myself, Keane. Today we'll be taking you through our ideas on how to improve the Lidl's current training programme. The brief topics we'll be covering today will be our assessment brief, our chosen competency, our current training scenario, pilot programmes, platform operations, maintaining results, and then wrapped up by Adam then at the end with a conclusion. We first looked at our assessment brief and we realised with the growth of our technology in the FMCG sector, we realised that there's a real need for us to improve and take advantage of this growth to improve our training scenario, to improve our customer experience and our increased store efficiency. We chose our training and development as our main topic to look at as it's the easy accessibility of e-learning. And I'll pass you on to Yvonne then, and she'll take it.
Right, so today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the current training scenario within Lidl. So as you all know, Lidl is a very fast-paced environment which is solely focused on hitting productivity and very KPI focused. So this leads to a lack of time in-store for training. At the minute, there's no actually in-store induction for employees. They're required to travel to the RDC to get all their training. So this is very costly and it's inefficient use of time. It's costly first because employees have to pay the expenses for actually traveling to the RDC, sometimes up to a travel time of 2 hours each way. And then also it's inefficient use of time as employees, again, they're gone out of stores for a long time. And also for the coordinators of the courses, there's a lot of time involved in making sure that basically all the employees that need to attend the training can come on the same day. They have to organise the facilities and all that for the training, so there's a lot of time wasted there as well. So basically the employees have to travel to the RDC to receive the training. New starters have to attend for 2 days. Two induction days, people wishing to progress to management have to complete the OBOM, which is One Business, One Management, and this is all multiple trips to the RDC. And on these training days, most of the training that you receive in the RDCs are done through videos and through leaflets, just listening to people and then taking away workbooks to fill out at home. So through the online e-learning platform, you could put all the videos, employees can do all their training all online without the cost and expense of actually travelling for a couple of hours to receive. So it's much more efficient price-wise and time-wise. The other thing with the Learn to Lidl workbooks, people are giving them at the RDCs but they still have to bring them home to fill them out, which it leaves it open to basically getting external help to fill them out. So they can get somebody else to do them because they're paperback then as well, they're easily damaged. Sometimes they're returned to the RDCs via internal post, which also leaves it open to being lost in the post. So with the online e-learning, this kind of cuts out the chance of all this happening. And I'm just going to talk to you just a little bit about how you can measure this. So we've looked at D.L. Kirkpatrick's four-level framework of measuring. This basically is four different levels. Level number one is based on reactions. So this is measured immediately after the employee does their training, just to see if they're satisfied with the training. Because if they're unsatisfied immediately afterwards, chances are the training is going to be unsuccessful. The next one measures the cognitive success of the training. So this is basically measuring how much the employee has learned from the training. And this could be measured on e-platform measure by a little test at the end of every module just to measure how much the employees have actually learned. Level three is behaviours, which looks at how much of the skills learned is being transferred back into store to be used. This can be measured through through just observation from peer review and from managerial appraisals. And then finally is the results level. So this is measured from pre-training and post-training times. So you basically compare results and performances in-store from pre-training and compare them to post-training and see is there an increase in productivity and better KPIs in-store, and then you can still measure if there's a financial benefit of the training and if there's any tweaks around that need to be made. So that's just a little bit on that. So now I'm going to hand you over to Tamir.
Right, thank you, Yvonne. Right, I'm going to talk about the pilot training. Now, the objectives of implementation of online training in Needle is to improve store efficiency in customer experience and also in experience or and also in the skills of the current employees themselves. It's a great opportunity for customer assistants to progress to management level. Now, it is a costly program, so a pilot program is going to be created for this, which will last 6 months. It's going to work like this. We're going to take four stores out of each region, and the pilot program will be used for these four stores, and all the rest of the stores won't use it. This will show great correlation if the program was a success or whether it wasn't a success. It will be identified that the four stores which used the pilot program, the stores that didn't. Now, it was according to Rowden and J.R. in 2005 that the employees that have learned as a result from online training have a higher level of job performance and also a high level of job satisfaction. Now, it's very expensive, this program is going to be, but it will identify after the pilot program whether to use it or not. It is a great opportunity to upskill its staff. I'll pass it on to Antonio now.
So guys, now what's going to happen is I'm going to go with you through the interface. So that's the platform. That's the main page the employee is going to have access to when they start to get the online training. So just give me a second, bear with me. So here you go. So the employee has to put the personal number, firstly, and the password. So the password is going to be given by the training and development department. However, this password has to be changed as soon as possible. So the employee can just use the password once. Once the password is in, we're just going to click, you know, login. And then that's the second welcome page. So on the right-hand side, on the left-hand side here, you're going to see there's the new course. So Cosmin First, Lean Warehouse, Cash Apps and Pickups. So if you're in on the platform, you're going to see them straight away. And on the right-hand side here, you have the My Course. So this one here is the one you have completed, the ones you are in progress, and the ones you are incomplete. So let me just go back for the other page, just a second. And I will show you just a sample of what would be the e-learning training. So let's just try the Cosmo First model 5. So that's the, each model is gonna have like two characters. In this case, have Darina. So the two characters are gonna run the course with the employee. So let's just get started. So there's a small introduction here. So the character is gonna introduce herself or himself, just explain what the course is about and how long it's gonna take. And in this case here, you see Darina, she's talking about it took them 3 months to build the whole customer first model 5. Let's just keep moving. And that's the agenda. So the agenda is gonna be covered on this customer first model is gonna be customer service excellence, the extra mile, high performing, and customer service, conclusion, and online tests. So I'm just gonna talk about the online test here. This one the employee has to do, because otherwise that's one of the way you can measure if the online training is actually having a great impact on the company. So the employee has to do that online training, that's online test, and it's gonna be actually our idea that the online test is gonna be done at the back office, so that there's no cheating around, so there's actually someone taking care. It doesn't mean that the SM or the SM has to be there, so but you have the whole the environment which you have CCTV as well. Yeah, so now I'm gonna pass you to Adam and he's gonna go through a little bit more about the product. Just a second. Here you go.
Yeah, thank you, Antonio. One of the main problems by implementing this e-learning system is trying to maintain results and the security of it. So for maintaining results, Antonio briefly mentioned that we're going to have an internal exam. This exam will be done in the back office. It can be supervised by your SM or deputy if they have time. But mainly as well, that there's cameras in the back office. There's people constantly use the back office in and out throughout the day. So it'd be quite hard to cheat in the back office when there's a camera looking or you're unaware of who's about to walk in the door. Then they'll keep the records. They'll compare the records from the employees in store and against stores that don't use the training program. And then there'll be constantly feedback on this program through with your employee and employer. So as an employee, you'll be able to make suggestions on what you thought worked really well and what changes you would make for the future. And also then your employer will be able to go through it, look at your results and see what sort of level a customer assistant you are or whatever level you are in store. Nextly, security is a issue. With the We Are Little books, they're being taken home. And competitors can easily get one of them to hold one of their books and then they see what level Little are training their customer assistants to be. Little have over 5,000 employees, which would be quite hard to control a database of all these employees. And this kind of might raise concern. The back office, again, it's under supervision of cameras and things like that. Stolen information could be a big thing, but it's happening as it is already with people. Competitors can easily get control or get one of them books. Where online, we went through 6 implementations of how to keep your website secure with implementing passwords. Employees won't be able to download anything. It'll literally be given their username and password, and that's the only way they can access the website. And then just in their data protection, it's just making sure all the information stored on the website is kept confidential and that there's only your manager or SOM who can really see what level you're at. And now I'll be moving on to conclusion. So our assessment was with the fast growth in FMCG's business to use and implement something with technology to improve 5 options. We went with training and development and we went with the e-learning system. And we think this is a very efficient way that will help productivity and time costly. It is a very expensive program, but I think under used rightly and with the money put into it to force, it can be a big advantage in the future of the company to be able to control and measure our staff. And that's our project, and any questions? Thank you.